The Mr. Men and Little Misses love to dine in Dillydale's many restaurants. It gives them a break from cooking and means they can enjoy spending time with their friends. But best of all, eating out in a restaurant means someone else does the dishes.
I'm delighted to be dining here tonight. This is certainly the fanciest restaurant in all of Dillydale. Now I beg you to be on your best behavior. Good manners are very important.
Enough of your talk. Let's eat.
Good evening, Mr. Bernickety and Mr. Rude. Would you like a table for two?
No, I'm waiting for a bus.
I have a reservation for 7:30. I requested your best table.
I don't seem to have you in my book, Mr. Pernickety. I do have Mr. Bump arriving at 8 o'clock.
Do I look like Mr. Bump? Oh, forgive me. Would you happen to have a table for two, Miss Helpful?
Why, certainly. Come this way.
Oh, this is lovely.
Oh, wait. This is the table that's reserved for Mr. Bump. I'll seat you at our next best table.
This is your next best table?
Not really, but it's the only one available without a reservation. Your waiter will be right with you.
But I had a reservation.
Fine dining, my food.
Mr. Rude. A napkin belongs on your lap. And please, elbows off the table. Show some manners.
I'll give you manners.
Mr. Rude, whatever you are going to do, please don't. We don't want to be asked to leave.
Hey, can we get that baguette over here?
Mr. Pernickety, you should know better than to throw cutlery across a restaurant.
It wasn't me. I knew. Miss Helpful, if you wouldn't mind, we don't know where our waiter is. However, we are both quite hungry and wondered if we might just order the house special for the two of us.
I'll tell your waiter.
Thank you.
Would you stop that noise? I cannot hear myself think.
That's it! I have had enough. You are quite possibly the most ill-mannered dinner companion I have ever known.
Mr. Pernickety, please don't disturb our customers.
It's not me, it's him.
I'm afraid I must ask you to leave.
Leave? But what are you going to do about Mr. Root?
Well, he's welcome to stay and we'll enjoy a delicious meal free of charge as our way of apologizing for your horrible manners.
It's the least you can do.
But he... But I...
Mr. Pernickety was right. This place is fantastic.
Thanks for helping out today, Mr. Bump. Hard to run a restaurant without clean dishes.
You know me, Mr. Strong. Always up for a new challenge.
Here's where you work. Oh, heavy. Phew. Now put these dirty dishes in these racks and send them down the belt to the machine. No need to rinse the dishes off beforehand. This wash is pretty powerful. 1,000 jets of water.
1,000 jets, eh? That is impressive!
Mr. Strong! Ah. We need you out front! There's a loose hamster in the dining room, and he's not on the menu, you know.
Oh, go on. This sounds simple enough. I'll be fine.
Here you go.
There really are a lot of hungry people out there.
Yeah, I know. Oh, here you go again.
Oh!
Oh no! Stop! Oh, poopity poop! Lemonade! No!
Mr. Bump, the restaurant's full, and we're out of clean dishes. This is no time to be taking a break. Poop!
It's a good thing I'm a morning person. Who else is going to get up this early to make sure Dillydale has fresh currant buns at the crack of dawn? Now, let's see. Flour, sugar, milk, and just a little yeast to help the dough rise. Oh, turn it on, let it all mix up. La 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 la.
Ah, Mr. Nosey, there's nothing like a fresh, hot currant bun.
Ah, couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Small.
Makes getting up at 5 a.m. worthwhile.
Yes, not to mention it's a good time of day to check out the neighbourhood.
What's going on in there, Nose?
Looks like Miss Calamity has the dough in the mixer.
And scrumptious dough it is.
I can't remember if I added the yeast. Oh, I don't think so.
Now she's adding yeast.
Then we've got some time before those currant buns are ready to eat. Oh, how about a game of jacks to while away the hour?
Oh, Mrs. Small, when have you ever known me to turn down a game?
Oh, a giant monster made of dough. Oh, oh no, oh no. I think I added too much yeast. Oh, get back. Back, you monster, get back. No. Oh, what a calamity.
Hippie, sorry to do that to you, old friend.
No need to apologise, Nose. You're a natural at jacks.
Thanks. Now, ninesies.
That's strange. I should be smelling those currant buns by now.
Help!
Hey, Mr. Small. I know we always come here on a Tuesday for a currant bun.
It wouldn't be a Tuesday without one.
Mr. Nosey! Mr. Small!
Maybe this time we could forget about currant buns and have scrambled eggs at the Dillydale Diner.
Ah, scrambled eggs on Tuesday. What a daring idea. I say, let's go crazy, Mr. Nosey.
I might even have extra toast.
Now that's what I call living!
Can you save me? Please! Oh, don't love talking, Miss Whoops. Do you love talking as well?
Shocking service. What does it take to get a waiter around here?
Hello, Mr. Grumpy!
I'll have the bangers and mash.
Don't you want to hear the specials?
No, thank you. Just the bangers and mash.
Coming right up!
What am I supposed to do with that?
Eat it! But peel it first. Banana skin is very hard to chew.
Look, I ordered bangers and mash.
You did? Where is my head? I have bad news, Mr. Grumpy. We're out of bangers and mash.
Oh, then I'll have the buttered noodles.
We're out of butter and noodles. Oh,
well, then I'll have raisin toast.
Guess what?
You're out of raisins?
Oh, no. We've got lots of raisins. They're just not getting along with the toast. So we have to keep them separate.
Well, what do you have?
Duck.
Duck? A la orange?
Well, more like la purple than la orange.
Oh, crooked cucumbers, I can't eat that.
Oh, goodness, no. He's much too cute, but he makes a wonderful dinner companion.
Here's some bird feed as an appetizer. And here's your bill. You can pay on the way out.
You gonna share that bird seed?
So the next time you're dining out at a restaurant, remember your manners, or you may be asked to leave. Although not every restaurant has such strict rules.